The English-speaking skills of Melbourne's cabbies have been labelled poor by the head of a sweeping review into the taxi industry. Professor Alan Fells has suggested drivers could face more stringent language tests before they're allowed behind the wheel.
You don't have to look far for an opinion on how to improve Victoria's taxi industry.
The drivers are more knowledgeable about Melbourne.
Maybe cleaner cabs.
But in the first submissions of a review into the taxi industry, a top gripe was communication, with complaints too many drivers are unable to speak basic English. Crown Casino has called for drivers to undergo a tougher language test before being allowed out on the road.
People tend to communicate in English, right? That is the common language, and that is where a lot of it is falling down.
The man charged with overhauling the industry agrees.
People who know the system keep telling us there are language problems of drivers.
Public submissions into the review of the taxi industry are still being received, but among the other suggestions, a Brownlow Medal-style reward for good driving, free licences for drivers, and a review of driver wages.
While the results of the review won't be known for another 12 months, tourism bodies say our system is far below that of other major cities around the world, and changes can't come soon enough.
Professor Fells has also hinted at changes to the way drivers are paid.
There are many invisible hands in the till when you or I pay a taxi.
Get about $7. Drivers get half of that, $3.50. How many people work for $3.50 an hour?
David Woywood, 10 News.